Eyeglasses. We commonly see eyeglasses on a daily basis. Have you ever seen eyeglasses closely? Have you ever tried to feel their lens with your hands? Do they have similar thickness throughout? The answer is no. Lenses are not uniform throughout, but thicker in the middle and thinner at the edges, or sometimes vice versa. So what is the reason for this variation in thickness? What will happen if light passes through this lens? Would it be called reflection or refraction? The answer is simple. Refraction, because the lens is transparent. Now, if refraction is taking place, does it also have some rules? You will get answers to some of these similar questions through today's video. What is lens? First of all, we need to know what these lenses are. There are broadly two types of lenses. One is converging lens and the other one is diverging lens. Like mirrors, the lenses which converge the light are called converging lenses, and the lenses which diverge the light are called diverging lenses. Types. Convergent and divergent lenses are broadly of six types: double convex, plano convex, converging meniscus, double concave, plano concave, and diverging meniscus. These lenses are called spherical lenses. Out of these six types of lenses, we will only talk about two in our upcoming videos: double convex and double concave. They are usually known as convex lenses and concave lenses. Formation. Like spherical mirrors, these lenses are also made from the arc of the sphere. The difference is that another arc of glass is bounded with the first one in place of polishing it from one side, and a transparent material is filled in the middle. As we know that every distance in case of mirrors was taken from P. Here in lenses, every distance is taken from O, which is also called optical center of the lens. As they have two surfaces, they have two focuses too, which are represented by F1 and F2. Twice the distance from O to F1 and F2 are called 2F1 and 2F2 respectively. And just like a mirror, all these points are found on the principal axis. Rules of image formation. Do you remember the 2 plus 4 rule of the mirrors? There are only three cases in lenses. In case 1, if the ray of light is traveling parallel to the principal axis, after refraction, passes through the focus located on the other side of the convex lens and appears to diverge from the focus located on the same side of the concave lens. In case 2, if the ray of light passes through the focus of the convex lens or appears to go towards the focus of the concave lens, then after refraction, it will emerge parallel to the principal axis. In case 3, if the ray of light passes through the optical center, then after refraction, they will emerge without any deviation. Now a question may be arising in your mind that the light was refracted on two different surfaces of the lens, but why this deviation is not shown here? The question is absolutely right. There will be refraction on both the surfaces of the lens, but lenses we take into consideration are too thin. That's why a straight line in place of deviation is shown here. Image formation by concave lens. Let us use these rules in this activity. Through this activity, we will get to know the refraction of light through a concave lens. To perform this activity, we need a concave lens having a focal length of 15 cm, a sheet, a candle, and a screen. Remember, in the case of a convex mirror, we can only place the object in two places. But here, because of having two surfaces, we can place the object in different places. Let's try it. First of all, a straight line must be drawn on the sheet and a point is placed in the middle of the line, which will be named O. All the distances will be taken from this point. F1 and F2 should be inscribed at a distance of 15 cm from O, and 2F1 and 2F2 at a distance of 30 cm. In the first case, let's put the candle at infinity. Do we see any image on the screen? No! This means that the concave lens creates a virtual image in this case. If we remove the screen and look, we can find that the image is made at the focus on the first side, which is highly diminished in size and erect. In the second case, if we bring the candle a little closer from infinity, what will happen? We will not see any image on the screen. Then slowly bring the candle closer to O. Even then, nothing is visible on the screen.
So it would be correct to conclude that no matter what the case, concave lenses always form virtual images.
If we remove the screen and see, we can find that the image seems to be forming somewhere between F1 and O. The image is diminished in size and erect as well. The summary of image formation for both the cases of concave lenses is given in this table. Concave lenses are used to make eyeglasses. Also, they are used as lenses of flashlight. We will learn about eyeglasses in the following chapters. Through this video, we have learnt about various types of lenses, nomenclature of various points of lenses, rules of image formation, and refraction by concave lenses. Hope you liked this video. We will meet in the next video.